People from all over the world have been quick to condemn this week's terrorist attacks. Some of the strongest words of condemnation have come from Muslims living within the United States. Ahmed Tharwat lives in Minnetonka. He's the host and producer of Belakhdin, an Arab American television program that airs right here on Twin Cities Public TV. He has a sister-in-law who was in the World Trade Center when the planes crashed into it. She managed to escape. We're pleased about that. On Thursday, Ahmed wrote a commentary for the Star Tribune in which he grappled with the horror of this week's news from the perspective of an Arab Muslim American. Ahmed, nice to see you again. My goodness, what were your immediate thoughts on Tuesday?
To be honest with you, there was no thoughts going through my mind. It's all been taken by a host of emotions that really I couldn't break it down to one thing. And it's a confusion and it's numbness is really what comes in my mind. And as I mentioned in my article, I really sick that my sound, I wish there was like a, this is a survival episode that went to Ari was something that's an we talk about as Arab Americans they've been singled out, and you hear those some of Laden and other Arab names and how that affects the Arab community. I'm really quite taken by the Arab American response and how that really galvanized. It's like as it's awakening to the American people how vulnerable our system are, no matter how superpower and technology. But it was also awakening to the Arab American. I think it assured them how American they are, because they feel the same pain, they have the same thing, and they always been in doubt: are they Americans or they are Arab American? There was always that kind of borderline, but I think this experience will assure them how American they are, because they felt the same way that most of the American had.
There's Arab terrorists, there's also enormous and rather unfair stereotyping in the media about Arabs, and you talk in your article about guilt by association quite a bit. How are we going to break that down?
To be honest with you, I have no problem when somebody comes into me and tell me, you know, up front, I don't like you, I'm a terrorist. I mean, that's nothing. I should tell the American people, do not be afraid to go and talk to the Arab and tell them how you feel. I think that what I really taken me when people give you that look, that they don't want to even talk to you. And you know, you're walking by, that look has so many questions, profound questions, than when somebody, you know, lift the phone, an idiot, and say, you know, I'm going to kill you. This is very rare, but I think the American needs to just go there and show them how what this country stands for. And the same thing for the Arab community. The Arab community needs to go out there and step on a plate, define themselves, and don't let the thugs define them. And I think we tend to wait in the back and let people violence define us. And I think it's time for the Arab American to go out there and tell them what is really being an Arab, what is being a Muslim. Islam doesn't stand for this. Islam stands for building, not destroying buildings.
I was going to ask you, can you explain to people, Islam forbids the taking of any innocent life, yet Osama bin Laden is talking about a holy war. How do you, can you
Osama bin Laden
explain
is
this?
As Muslim as Timothy McVeigh, as my brother always say. Osama bin Laden is a freelancer, the guy, it's like a white elephant. It's been kind of credited for so many things. A lot of bad, you know, horrible thing going on in this world is blaming for Osama bin Laden. I think what the question should be, or what the concern should be, not Osama bin Laden, but the people listen to him, and how the Muslim countries, with the desperation and undemocratic leaders, building a ground for the people who can Osama bin Laden recruit them. And I think the American needs to look at the relationship with the Muslim and Arab countries, with supporting leaders that are very undemocratic, they're suppressing their people. And I think that if there is any democratic process in Saudi Arabia or Egypt or Jordan or any of those Arab countries, we wouldn't see people who are really willing to listen to Osama bin Laden. They'll have voice over there to. And I think they talk to the American because they know American can take this, and Americans is like a big brother that they can take these heads.
Very good. This has been good, helpful to have us on. You'll be on the national PBS program here following Almanac.
Not a lot of people know I'm a famous person now.
Okay. Well, we'll watch. This was great, and we'll watch for more of you coming up
Thank
next
time. Thank you for
hour.
Having me.
And your sister-in-law, by the way, is fine.
She's fine, and she gave me, actually, how I found out that her cellular phone was running from the Trade Center to in the streets. It's just a horrible feeling.
All right.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you, Ahmed.
Thank you.